Webby contacted a group of people and said, do you want to sing on the Smokey record? And they said, yeah. So they gave me a list of my songs. They picked their favorite song, and that's the song. We're trying to captivate some new audience members, and I would just like them to take away from it that somebody who is in their era or in their genre of music that they like is singing with me.
But, you know, thinking of, well, Smokey and Elton sound great on this together. Smokey and James is interesting. So, you know, it was really, really more about that, where their voices could fit, what it would leave, what it would sound like.
I heard John Legend sing Quiet Storm on one of his shows live. And after the show, I went over there and said, John, you should record that, man, please. He said, oh, Smokey, he said, that's a good idea, but he never did until now.
I've been exposed to Smokey's writing since I was a very young child. It's been highly influential to me. His sense of phrasing and poetry and elegance. That voice is so singular and distinct and beautiful. And it just kind of floats on top of the record.
Group when I was probably about 11 or 12, and we called ourselves Five Chimes. Oh, I didn't know music was going to work out. All I knew is that I was doing it, and this was my lifelong childhood from like 4 or 5 years old coming true.
He's around not just because he's a great artist, a great singer, and a great poet, but because everyone loves him.
I'm standing in the mirror and I'm shaving. And I'm just looking, I'm kind of humming the thing. I thought to myself, I said, now what if a person had cried so much until if you really got close on them and examined their face, you would see tracks that their tears had made.
The tracks of my tears.
Smokey Robinson first came into my life when I was a teenager collecting soul records. I was lucky enough to pick Tracks of My Tears because I've always loved this song. Probably maybe the greatest pop song I've ever written.
For somebody like Elton to say it, to one of my songs, is one of his favorite songs and he thinks it's the greatest song ever written, I can't beat that.
It's the classic opening line for a song. I don't like you, but I love you. Seems that I'm always thinking of you. It's like, what? Just brilliant.
I don't want you, but I need you.
The music was infectious to the point of you made out with it, you made love to it, you went to high school to it. It was just a huge era.
I had no idea what Steven was going to do with You Really Got a Hold of Me. So he did the rock. With the big screaming guitars and all that stuff like that. So that's who he is. He's a guy that is rock.
And he's still relevant. He still sings and he still plays. He still sings great. It's just a national treasure.
Yo, that felt good. Let's not lose that. Let's go right away again.
Okay.
Jessie J sounded to me like this soulful black girl who was from New York, East LA, or somewhere like that. You know?
And if you want it, you got it forever.
Come to find out she's this little English girl who is one of the best singers I've ever heard. Her version or her take on Cruising is so soulful. When they first played it for me, she had done it before I did it. When Randy first played it for me, I said, I don't want to sing this, man. I said, we should just put this on the record just with her singing, you know, because she absolutely killed me. She annihilated. My greatest joy of feeling other people in terms of my songs is, first of all these people that I'm working with on this record are professionals. And when they sing my songs, it's a joy. To hear Stephen or John or Elvin or any of those people sing my songs is a dream come true. But however, that same dream comes true for me if I hear you humming it. If I hear you just singing it around your house or in the shower. I just love hearing my songs sung by other people.